for the invitation to be a speaker at the Economist Forum today and to speak about the future of money. My name is Dr. Ruža Ignatova. I hold a PhD in law. I have always been very interested in financial services and worked about 6 years with McKinsey in Eastern Europe, actually when the crisis hit us really, really bad. I was spending my time in Russia with Sberbank, and it was an interesting time. I want to speak today about, as I said, the future of money, the future of payments. And I am, how to say, a bit sad to listen to the speaker before me, who are having such a gloomy outlook, focusing on all the issues that the region faces, and showing us a future where we have to do a lot of catching up in Eastern Europe, a lot of work, a lot of tasks, a lot of issues. So I would like to take a bit of a different approach. I would like to show people that Eastern Europe can innovate, that Eastern Europe can bring growth, that we are not just a follower, country catching up, but actually that we also can show the world that we can do a lot. Our company, which is very young, 1.5 years old, actually writes history currently with cryptocurrency. OneCoin currently reached a market capitalization of $1 billion 3 days ago, which makes me extremely proud. And we have a network of 650,000 users over 190 countries, and we come from Eastern Europe. We started actually in this country, we had the idea in this country, and we do not only describe the future of money, actually we take a very active approach of shaping the future of money. So, Southeastern Europe is a very good place to live, and I'm born here. I have been not raised here the whole time, but I feel home here. But however, even we cannot take an isolated approach and see ourselves as an own microcosmos. The world is getting smaller and smaller. We are living in a world with globalization. Technology is developing at a speed that makes me dizzy sometimes, seeing what happens around us. And all the innovative companies like Facebook, Google, Apple, all of them, unfortunately, are either not even coming from Europe, or like we are just a follower and just saving all our money in Eastern Europe, which is a lot of money for us to go and to buy the newest iPhone outside. So with globalization, the world becomes much smaller, much more transparent, and the needs of consumer and of companies actually change a lot. We have a lot more needs for cross-border transactions. Even as a simple customer, I have to do a lot of shopping, a lot of things outside my country. So of course, this is a need that we need and we have to address with a company. So what is the future of money? In my opinion, the future of money, or a big part of the future of money, will be outside the banking system as we know it today. Traditional businesses either will change or new entrants will come in the market. One of the most spectacular entrants that I've been following now for about 5 years is Bitcoin. Now, Bitcoin is a cryptocurrency, the first cryptocurrency, the biggest cryptocurrency currently. And these people who created Bitcoin, nobody officially knows who they are, have my fullest respect for the innovation, disruption, and value creation that they actually did to the financial market. Of course, wherever there's value creation, speculators come, and a lot of turmoil can happen, but these people created something new and something really exciting. Bitcoin and the blockchain technology, which makes financial services independent from governments, independent from regulators even, and independent from banks as we know them, already starts changing the world we live in. However, Bitcoin until now and the more sophisticated cryptocurrencies have been a payment system, an investment system for the either very sophisticated people out there with a very, very solid IT background, for the smart ones, or for the elite who has a lot of money and diversifies their portfolio with a new exotic investment like Bitcoins. The market is still not very big, with a market capitalization fluctuating between 2 and 3 billion, transactions happening every day about 200 million euro. So we still have a lot of potential to grow in the cryptocurrency market, but we see a start. So
We have been, or are we still an emerging market? I'm not sure what is politically correct to say, but emerging markets are out there. And we can speak about Latin America, we can speak about Asia, we can speak about Africa, extremely interesting market actually, which is like catching up now. And we can speak about also the small Asian countries. In all these countries, we have an issue that we also had here actually. A lot of people who are underbanked, unbanked, or just forgotten by the big players. Why? Because they're poor, because they have needs that are not that interesting in the transactions, or simply because some of these people do not have proper documents. I have been in countries where people, every one of them has a smartphone, but has no proper ID card. So how do these people bank? I have been in Singapore and seeing Indian people working very, very hard to support families in India. How do these people send money to their families and to their loved ones? Remittance business in Dubai, all the Filipinos working there and pushing economy. What do these people do? What they do is they either go to a bank to do foreign exchange, they go to a Western Union outlet, and they pay high, high fees. Because why? We as a financial sector charge always most the ones who are the poorest, who are like the ones with the needs that nobody else can serve. If you're an affluent customer, if you have a lot of money, the banks will fight for you. They'll give you cards for free. They'll do their best to make you happy. But the people out there, the mass customers, the ones who actually change the world, the ones who are working for economy, these people are underserved, underbanked, and I believe that cryptocurrency can change their life. And not only me, actually, I think Bill Gates believed the same and said that cryptocurrency can make a huge difference for emerging markets. So, what is really the future of money? I believe that if cryptocurrency is spread out there to the mass market, to people who can be made understand cryptocurrency, and as you say, cryptocurrency sounds very, very complicated, hidden, complex, can I do it? If we manage to make cryptocurrency actually accessible to people out there who are smart enough to understand a smartphone, who are smart enough to move and to work in an Asian country, if we make it simple, we could become actually the next mass phenomenon, like Google, like Facebook, become a network of active users. Until now, cryptocurrency did not make the leap, in my opinion, because it is not user-friendly, because it's not easy to use for the mass market, and because people perceive it as very difficult. So the person or the company who makes it actually to make cryptocurrency easy to use, accessible in the markets that need it, and this is not the US, gentlemen, this is the emerging markets where people want to work with it, to use it. If we make cryptocurrency not only a tool for speculators and investors to make quick money, but make it usable, if we work on KYC, on documentation, on making it transparent and bringing cryptocurrency to the traditional world, with the regulators, by the way, the US actually government, 4 weeks ago, they said that cryptocurrency is actually in a status equal to commodities. So it means that actually cryptocurrency can be treated like virtual gold. Commodities is gold, is silver, platinum, and apparently bitcoins. So the future of money can be searched, I think, outside the banking system because we are still more flexible. We do not fight the issues that the banks have. And because we think that the next big thing is based on technology, on the internet, and on the network phenomenon that we see in all these big companies out there. I think if we manage to provide a consistent strategy, a case to use the currency, and an easy access, which is aligned with the regulators out there, transparent, safe, cryptocurrency can actually be one of the preferred methods of payment, and not only bank transfers, card transfers, and all the traditional ways that we deal money with. My future, or my vision actually, is the one card, making cryptocurrency one currency like the euro, like the dollars, that you just can go and spend with your card, which can be a Visa, MasterCard, China Union Pay, whatever, make it a real currency that people just can go and spend out there. I have done my job whenever all of you can go with their card and just spend one coins for a dinner. This is when cryptocurrency actually became real for me. And I'm very, very curious how the next 2 to 3 years will work out for all of us. And I hope I'm right that the future is with technology and with us. Thank you very much.